Welcome to Statistics in Excel video number 15. As always, if you want to download this workbook, go to my college website link, and there it is, Business 210 Chapter 2. Hey, in this exciting video, we're going to do frequency distribution, relative and percent frequency distribution in a pie chart using the pivot table feature. Hey, let's scroll down here. And there is our data set. As always, we've been using this throughout this chapter. We have a bunch of sales transaction for the company www.boomerangs.com. And these are dates, customer age. Here's the product name. And what we want to do is create a frequency distribution and count the number of each product type that we sold. So a key to a pivot table is that your data has to be set up correctly. We have field names at the top, records, blank spaces around the whole table, and no blank spaces in the table. Once we have that, we can click in one cell. Don't do this, because then it will try to build a pivot table just from that. Click in one cell and go to Insert, and in the Tables group, Pivot Table, and then Pivot Table. I'm going to click Escape. If you build pivot tables a lot, the keyboard shortcut for it is excellent. Hit your Alt key. Whoa, look what happens. It shows us little key tips. N for so hit N. And then V for pivot table, so hit V. And then T for pivot table, so hit T. I'm going to click Escape. And once you do this a lot, you get the hang of it. You just go Alt NVT. Now, this is the one-step method in 2007. It's got the range right. As long as you set up your data correctly, you can always verify it. And when you see that, that means you can click and collapse and highlight whatever you want. We want to send this to an existing sheet, so I'm going to click there. And I'm going to find cell L20, so it should say L20. And then click OK. To do. Now, the trick to this, since we're counting product's name, we need to drop it into the row. So you click on the field and drop it into the row. Oh, look at that. Just like that, it gives us a unique list of items. Those are all the boomerang types that we sell. And the trick is, if you're doing a frequency table, you drop it once to row, and then you click on it and drag it a second time to values. Now, I'm going to close this field list. If you want to open your field list at any time, you can right-click and say Show Field List, Escape. Now, I want to immediately format it. So I'm going to go up to the Pivot Table Tools Context Sensitive Ribbon and go to Design. And then Layout, remember, I have my screen small, so yours should look much bigger. Layout, Report Layout, and we want Show in Tabular Form. Show in Tabular Form. Looks like it already was in Tabular Form. Now, I want to apply some style to this, so I'm going to go up to the Design again and click the More button and select some basic style, maybe something like this one here, and click on that one. And sure enough, there we have it. So formatting, if it's not, hey, what happened to my ribbons? Oh, yeah, if you're not clicked inside the pivot table, they go away. That's why they're called context-sensitive ribbons. Again, if you don't have this report layout show tabular, then the field names don't show up. And it's convenient to have the field names. Hey, but those are a little bit long. I want shorter names. So we saw how to drop the two fields. We saw how to format it. Now we want to see how we can change the field names. Now, there's a bunch of ways to do it. But the easiest way is just to click there. And I don't want a long name. I just want to say boom name. So just type boom name and then Enter. Now I can come up to this column here, and when I point between L and M, I can double click and it will change the size. That's called best fit. It goes down all the rows and finds the biggest one and then fits it. Let's change the name here, and we're going to call this frequency, and then Enter and do the same thing. We'll click up here and double click. There we go. There's our frequency distribution with a pivot table. Once you get it down, it's much faster than doing formulas. Now, we can see the same patterns as we recognized before, but wait a second. They're all kind of mixed up. Well, let's sort. I'm going to click somewhere in the one cell here in the numbers here, the value area, and right click, sort, and then I'm going to say sort largest to smallest, or Z to A. And just like that, it sorts it. And there it is. We can recognize our patterns. That's the point of a frequency distribution. Yanaki the most. Carlota Aspen second most, and these, oh, look at that one. That's just a few items. Now, we need to create a relative frequency and a percent frequency. Watch this. This is a great trick. Once you have your pivot table all set up perfect, formatting, names, and everything, highlight it and Control-C, and then click down here. I'm going to click in L29 and Control-V. Oh, that is so cool. Now, I want a relative frequency. Now, you don't have to build formulas. You just right-click and point to value field settings. And actually, there's lots of great things here to change. You can change the name. You can change the function. We want to go back here, show values as. This is so powerful. Remember, relative frequency, we compare each item to the total with division. So let's click in this area, show values as in the normal. No way. If I scroll down, there's a percentage of column, and that's what you want. And then we need to, because this is a relative frequency, we'll change the name of that in a second. This will come out as a percent format. And if you click, you can see that's percent format. So I'm going to right-click value field settings. We're going to change this name up here to relative space. And we're going to go to the number format, and we want to apply general. Number, general. Click OK, click OK. And there it is, our relative frequency. Now, we want to do, these are proportions or relative frequencies or probabilities. And these are used especially for planning or making calculations, like what is the percentage of materials for each? What is the planning schedule? Now, I want to do a percent frequency distribution. So I'm going to highlight the whole thing, Control-C. Click right here in cell L38, Control-V. And then I'm going to right-click value field settings. And I'm going to change the number format back to percent. Number format, percent. Click OK, click OK. And there we have it. Now, we want to build a pie chart. A pie chart is particularly useful when we have a relative frequency distribution. I'm going to highlight this whole thing, not including the total. And then I'm going to go up to Insert, Charts, and Pie. We'll do this first pie here. By the way, three-dimensional pies are not very good because they distort the proportions or the percentages. I'm going to click that first one right there. I'm going to close this pivot chart filter because it's based on a pivot table. I'm going to point to the upper edge and hold Shift and click and drag in to make it pretty small. Click on the edge with my Move cursor and click and drag. And then I'm going to click right here and delete that legend. I think I'll expand it a little bit right there. Now, I want to change this label here. So I'm going to click up in that label right there and hit the F2 key and type equals. Notice I type hit F2 and then equals. The formula bar is ready for me to link that label to a cell. So I'm going to scroll up, and I'm actually going to click on cell A18. Then I'm going to scroll over to where I have my pie and hit Enter.
Name.
Hey, look at that. That's a pretty big name. I want to change the font size. So I'm going to go up to the Home, change the font size to 9. Now, I want to add some data labels here. So I'm going to go up to the Pivot Chart Tools and Layout. And in the Labels area, I'm going to say Add Data Labels. And all the way down at the bottom is More Data Labels Options. And I'm going to say up here under Label Options, show the category name, the values, and any leader lines. And then click Close on this. Now I can click to the edge here and try and make it a little bit bigger. And sure enough, I could I have a chart now that's a pie chart. Now, why do we do the pie chart instead of like the column? The main reason is because these are percentage frequencies. And in fact, we need to change that. We better click right there and highlight this word relative and type percent. The percent frequencies are percentage. You're comparing all the parts to the whole, and that is the definition of a pie chart, comparing the parts to the whole. Let's look back over here. So that's for a percentage frequency distribution. Let's click back over here. Now over here, when we did our column chart, that's good when you have just a straight frequency distribution. You're looking at the actual numbers. All right, that's it. We will see you next video.